Based on the CIA's data, the country with the highest life expectancy is Monaco, with an average of 89.5 years old. In the United States, it drops to about 80. In Canada, about 82. In the United Kingdom, around 81. Across the world, this number can fluctuate dramatically and drop all the way down to the low 50s in certain less developed countries. But for the sake of this video, let's assume your life expectancy is on the higher side of the world's average and that you will have no incidence of health complications or tragedies and that you will live to 82 years old. 82 years on this planet as yourself, not too bad, but that's from birth. In terms of your remaining time in life, we have to subtract however old you are right now from 82. For the sake of this video, let's say you are 22 years old, as that is generally an age when a lot of people fully begin their careers. After subtracting that, at this point, you now have 60 more potential years of life, which equates to 21,900 days or 525,600 hours. Still not too bad. But if you get an average of 8 hours of sleep per night, 175,200 of those hours disappear, and you now have just less than what is equal to 40 years of waking life left. That brings your life expectancy down 20 years. That's kind of scary, but it gets a lot scarier if the following is true for you. A 2017 survey indicated that about 50% of US workers describe themselves as unsatisfied or unhappy in their job. In another 2017 study conducted worldwide, when asked anonymously, 85% of workers admitted to disliking or hating their job. At such a large percentage, it is rather likely that one of these people might be you. Or perhaps you don't necessarily hate or dread your job, but you find yourself rarely ever enjoying it or feeling inspired by it, and are always wishing for the weekend, always wanting the week to be over and for it to be Friday night. If this is the case and your life enjoyment is based almost entirely on the weekend, let's see what happens when we subtract all the weekdays from your remaining 40 years of life. There is an average of 260 workdays in a year, not including holidays. After subtracting those across your remaining 40 years, your number of days goes from 14,600 all the way down to 4,200, leaving you with only about 11 years. But if you figure you retire at an average age of around 63, you might say that you should get some of those days back. But if you also figure that in the US, the chance of having a disability or mental impairment is 68% for people over the age of 65, then this age isn't exactly a time of your life to hold out for and claim as years filled with happiness and enjoyment. So in fact, I would argue that in terms of desirable life, we should actually take at least a portion of those days away. First, let's give you them all back. But then let's consider that after the age of 65, as you grow older and older, the likelihood of developing health conditions or having existing health conditions worsen only increases. So as a rough, generalized average, across all the years after retirement, all the way up until death, let's say a person has somewhere around 2 good, healthy, enjoyable days out of every 7. Now, you are exactly right back where you were, with 11 years of remaining life. In living for the weekend, you went from what first sounded like a decent 60 years of remaining life all the way down to only 11. And as an extra kicker, what if you have weekends that aren't that good? Weekends where you have to do things that you don't want to do, like house chores, yard work, dealing with annoying personal stuff, or even going into work to catch up on things. That's at least another year or more off of your remaining life. If you are 22, your waking life expectancy for life you want to live is now equivalent to around the age of 32. Regardless of your age, who you are, what you do, or the exact accuracy of these numbers to your life, if you live for the weekends, the point holds true. The idea that anyone would accept to live a life where this amount of it is wished away, where such a huge quantity of time is spent not wanting that time to happen, where such a small percentage is spent enjoying it and living in the moment. For anyone that has any sliver of hope in not living like this, it is borderline insanity to accept. Sure, there are responsibilities we must attend to in life. Sure, there are things we are going to have to do that we don't always want to do. Sure, every day of our job and career can't always be fun or how we want it to be. But to work a job or be in a career or be at a company that you don't enjoy or find fulfillment in at least a majority of the time, you're essentially signing away most of your life. Life is extremely short. If you do out all of the math and consider every little trivial or self-maintenance oriented thing we spend time doing, even if you love what you do for work and don't subtract all the weekdays from your remaining life, the time we have is still frighteningly short. So it truly is so important that we do not give it away, that we are careful and conscious of what we exchange it for, that we do not let outside pressures from family, friends, or society convince us to just give it away blindly and choose jobs, careers, companies, or lifestyles that we don't personally enjoy or resonate with. That we don't become easily distracted or persuaded by short-term glitz and glamour that we know we don't really need, and that we try our best to avoid accepting anything less or making big mistakes that force us to have to. If you feel like you are constantly wishing for the weekend, only for it to come, and then in a blink of the eye, it ends and you are back at the same starting point on Monday, waiting for the weekend all over again. If you feel like you are anywhere close to living a life where you dislike almost every day of what you do, throwing each day into the trash of wasted time, perhaps you should spend some of your time trying to figure out how to make sure you don't waste any more of it.
Thank you for watching. If you found enjoyment and value in this video, please give it a thumbs up. Share your thoughts in the comments below. And if you are not already, be sure to subscribe to our channel. We are constantly coming out with new videos to help you experience life with clarity and wonder.